Hello guys, my name is Hamza Borakocuoğlu and today I'm going to talk about Arduino programming. So, what is Arduino? Arduino is a microcontroller platform based on open source information and easy to use hardware. Its software uses C and C++. Arduino boards are capable of reading inputs like lights with a sensor, user by a button, or a message sent from a friend, and change this input into an output like activating a motor, turning on some LEDs, or submitting something online. Arduino was invented at the Ivrea Interaction Design Institute in 2005 in Italy by 5 students as a tool for fast prototyping aimed at students without a knowledge in electronics or programming. Arduino is made as simple as possible for these kinds of people, so every student will not have a hard time learning it. As soon as it reached a wider community, different types of Arduinos were developed. All Arduino boards are completely open source, empowering users to build them independently and eventually adapt them to their particular needs. The software is open source too, and it is growing through the feedbacks and progress of users worldwide. Different needs requires different microcontrollers, so Arduino has too many different boards. Here is the most general Arduino Uno board used by millions of people in their projects. Over the years, Arduino has been a major part of thousands of projects, from simple objects to complex scientific devices. A worldwide community of creators has gathered around this open source platform. Their work have added up to an incredible amount of knowledge that can be accessible to everyone. Standard boards for mostly beginners are these boards named Arduino Uno, Nano, Leonardo, Micro. As you can see, every board has its unique designs for their specific needs and requirements. Advanced boards for more complex projects are vastly produced, and there is a lot of them, as you can see. For simply IoT projects, there are some microcontroller boards too, with most of them has an internet connector or Wi-Fi. I don't think there's Wi-Fi, but at least internet connection cable input. Arduino is easy to learn and use. It's inexpensive. Its software can be developed in Linux, macOS, and Windows, but unfortunately, most microcontroller systems are limited to Windows. Its documents are open source, so everyone that has an internet connection, which is most of the people in the entire world, can reach its documents, its data. The language can be expanded through C++ libraries for more complex programming in need. To use Arduino, we need to learn simple aspects of programming and also basic electronic laws, but the rest is easy because there are too many projects on internet for us to learn. Arduino's own website does contain programming language references. Here we have functions. Also, in the website you can click on each function to learn more about them. There are some variables and there are some structural syntax. For example, Arduino music instrument is simply playing music with Arduino. Arduino Uno fingerprint door lock is unlocking the door when the home residents scan their fingerprints through the Arduino's fingerprint reader. Arduino Car, Arduino Uno handheld game console. It's a simple snake game, which is which has an output LED console on it. Uno Home Automation, Uno, Arduino Uno Car Truck Simulator, and such laser tripwire alarm security system is actually an interesting project. Basic clocks and much more. Here is an RC car made with Arduino. The Arduino is receiving radio signals from the user's controller, and it creates outputs for steering rotor and thrust rotor to control the car. So here is my very simple chronometer project. I made it with an Arduino Uno and an LCD panel. Here I declared the LCD screen's connections on Arduino outside any void methods. The thing is, inside the void setup, you are declaring the variables. Outside the void setup, you are declaring the connections of the Arduino, and inside the loop segment, you are setting all the processes for your Arduino. Declaration of LCD screen is right here, liquid crystal LCD, RSE D4, D5, D6, and D7. I declared the screen connections before this sentence, so it connects it to the LCD panel's connection thing. Declaration of second minute and hour variables are outside the void setup, as I said. So here, in void loop is simply a loop. It runs every single clock rate, so it never stops. So how can we make a chronometer out of this? We have declared the output of the LCD screen to show chronometer. There is a delay function which delays the loop for 1 second to increase second by one. As you can see, each time this loop executes, second variable increases by one. At the end, there are if statements that checks the second and minute variables, that if they have reached 60. When second reached 60, second is again 0, and we add 1 to minute. Chronometer second to minute to hour change statements are here. So, the idea is, Arduino was created by college students, but today is used by the world. Arduino is capable of so many things, and its boundaries are our imagination. As long as we don't need advanced processes which requires computers, we can do anything we want with Arduino. We can create prank machines to automation devices. Everything is possible. All is in our reach with Arduino. Thank you for your listening and time. I'm going to set the download link in the description for Arduino IDE, the software. Thank you.